Hey guys, Stealth here, welcome back to Shipyard Champions. Today, we are playing as the Brick. The job was sent forth by Admiral Brother Monroe. Admirals, your job is not necessarily to defeat the enemy, but to exhaust their ammunition supplies as they fruitlessly waste thousands of shells trying to sink the unsinkable. Your forces will be a single battleship, and the enemy is going to have a battleship, a battlecruiser, a heavy cruiser, a light, and a DD from any nation. Scoring is simple. The Admiral with the most hits that were blocked by their ship's armor is the winner. The post-battle results screen shows exactly as how much or how many hits these were. So, let's go for a very, very, very tanky battleship. Generally, I tend to start out with all sorts of gear first. But this time around, I'm going to reverse that and I'm going to start it with the armor first. When it comes to resistance, that's also a very hefty, important skill here. 75, 88 for Dreadnought 2, 87 there, or 82 here. So I'm going to go with Dreadnought 2, because it is just a bit more resistant, and as such, hopefully will last longer. So, more armor, better hull, all the anti-torp. Well, I might not need all the anti-torp, because I need blocked hits from armor, not blocked torpedoes. Yes, what are we going to do with the armor? Well, as much as I can... 20 inch isn't even the max? Okay. Okay. Yeah, right. 20 inches of cunning armor. Oh, sorry, superstructure armor. Main deck. I don't know, 4 inch. And then... 20 inches in the cunning tower, whatever. 4 deck, aft deck, there. The job is to keep getting hit as many times as possible. It is the number of hits that were blocked, not the total amount of damage, right? So, if I'm at all capable of eliminating their battleship, that would help me a lot. Now, there is a very important caveat. If you are sunk, your score is zero. You cannot be sunk and still get points. So I need to be able to still take hits from destroyers and light cruisers, for example, but not get sunk by the enemy battleship. Now, let's say that the enemy battleship has the biggest guns possible. So that's going to be 13 inch. At least that's on this hull. And let's say that they really spruce up those guns with more shell pen. We're getting more shell pen from Dunite. We're getting slightly more shell pen from Ballastite, I think. 5% here. Yeah, no bonuses there. They're going to be firing heavy shells. They're going to be firing the cap ballistics. We're getting armor quality bonuses of 115%. So let's dial that in and say the enemy has 115% armor bonuses. That means that this gun can pen at about 10 kilometer range, 20 inches of armor. So the 20 inches of armor that I currently have is kind of required. The problem is, this thing won't float out of dock. Not with this level of protection. So let's reduce that and say I'm going to have 10 inches there, 10 inches there, and maybe 15 inches here. Because if I keep the ship bladed, I should still be able to get quite a lot of armor effectively from that. Does this rotate? Oh yeah, it does. Okay, nice. Okay, let's put a rangefinder on, check. Let's put some barbette armor on. Turbines don't really make that much of a difference, unfortunately. I cannot have cramped quarters because I'm taking a lot of hits and thus crew losses. It's up the displacement. Doesn't matter a whole lot. Oh. Come on, max it out. Now, beam and draft might actually help. I'm not sure if it really helps with the amount of protection that you're getting. I mean, I'm looking at water spread, stuff like that helps. Like, not having your water spread out. Because if you do get penned and you do start flooding, then the water starts spreading faster. Where can I save some weight? My engines are way too efficient for what I currently have. There's no penalty to being too efficient, it's quite the opposite. It's just that that funnel is... by that virtue, well, heavier than I actually need. Pitch is 35. What if I upsize the beam? It's Gonna reduce the pitch by quite a bit. If I increase the draft. Not bad. I know I'm sacrificing some stat bonuses, but it shouldn't be that bad. Because with a bigger beam, I'm going to get better accuracy. This takes away from that accuracy, but the whole ship just becomes heavier. And with that, potentially tankier. Ship repairs from flooding plus 15%. There is no debuff here for ship repairs from flooding. Yeah. So we pretty much made the ship wider and got more freeboard. And because of that, I didn't exactly finish fixing the pitch. But the ship should be slightly more stable as a whole. Yeah, I'm thinking of just going with a couple of 13 inches. Let's put a medium barbette over there. Put this here. I think this is the ship. I was going to put this back. Try and make the citadel a bit smaller. And with that, not have to have too much of a belt. There. So just 6 guns, really. It's just that my guns right now are probably a bit too good. At least when it comes to dealing with enemy battleships. We are starting at 10 kilometer range, so that 20.4 inches could come in handy. Especially if the enemy battleship is as heavily armored as I am. Although I rather doubt that. Like, it's possible, but I'd say not plausible. If I go back to one level lower, I'm looking at 19 inches pen, it's still way high. If I go semi-ballistics, 10 inches of armor, should be good enough. When it comes to my flash fire chance, that is something I have to address with haste. Because this thing is going to blow itself up. Holy shit, it's not getting better. Does that have to do with the shell size? Yes. Okay, light shells. Flash fire chance 13%. I'm going to increase these to soft cap ballistics. And yeah, I don't really think there's a whole lot more that I can do. I already got the best flash fire protection that I can get from the barbettes. Ballastite to cordite only makes it a lot worse. Hydraulic turret rotation. This slightly increases it. I don't really think that there's too much more that I can do to fix that number. It's just this early tech, it's pretty bad. It just does not nearly do what you want it to do. Yeah, okay, that helps a bit. I can reduce the range. That saves me quite a bit. And I know I'm only doing 17 knots, but I'm not going anywhere in a hurry. I'm not trying to go anywhere. The only thing that I might want to be able to do is turn pretty quick, so with an unbalanced rudder I can do just that. And then with the engine efficiency, I can probably speed back up again. As for secondary weapons, like, I don't really care. The things that I need to sink are the battlecruiser and the battleship. The CA, the CL, and the DD, they can keep shooting me all they want. Because their chances of actually getting a whole lot of damage in is pretty low. But what they might be able to do is give me a whole lot more hits that kind of got negated, if you will. I got a small citadel, a little small-ish. This turret's pretty far forward, but that has to do with the turret rotation. This thing won't spin freely now, will it? No, it will not. That is something I want to have happen. There, that's better. And this thing is also not yet free-spinning. Now it is. Okay. Good enough. I don't care for that 0.3. It's not really a priority. I'm not doing much about main decks and aft decks and fore decks because I don't find the chance of getting penned through the deck to be particularly high. We only have 30 minutes of in-game time, so I shouldn't really have to stick around for too long. And the most problematic thing that I foresee is the crew dying. I think that has a real risk to it. Now, I did move these shells down to low pen, semi-ballistics. With the low shell size, so let's go back up to capped. And with that, get about 15.9 inches of armor pen. That should be good enough. Can we do something a bit more about, I don't know, the conning tower is normally where I would store the additional weight, but I guess not. There, 15.3 inches of armor. That is a hefty brick. Okay, Byron, let's see what you got. And this is where the RNG is going to come into play. Now, the British have devised this contraption, for lack of a better term. It took the AI a while to come up with this beautiful piece of art. I mean, look at the main turret. Main turret behind a secondary turret that has a barbette. Most modern, normal ship designers do that the other way around. Now, this thing has relatively small guns. It's definitely not the threat I was expecting. It's 11.4s. So considering their range and angle, they have almost no chance to pen me, but I forgot the turrets and the barbettes, which in tandem with my flashfire chance is not necessarily good. When it comes to number of guns, they got a lot of 3.5 inchers, so that could be a benefit in this case, so long as those 11.4s don't pen. They also have a battle cruiser with 11.4s again. This feels a bit more as a reasonable design, although that turret is looking a bit odd as well. These 11.4s, same chance to pen. We've got their heavy cruiser. 24 3.1s, my friend, you're gonna stick around. I'm gonna keep this guy around. As long as it doesn't burn me down, we should be able to get a lot of hits from this. This guy, battle cruiser. Secondary wise, it's pretty limited. I might just put it out of its misery. And then the CL and the DD, I cannot see yet. So let's go, let's go even slower. And let's start landing some hits on the enemy. No, not the heavy cruiser. Dude, I need the heavy cruiser alive. I need the battleship dead. The brick. The Bayern. I mean, it's one of the most gun-wise bare-bones pieces of ships. Yes, I said ship that I've ever created. No secondaries. No casemates. No speed. This thing is sheerly designed to survive anything. And it seems to be already working, because the British battleship does not quite have the same luck. Now, when it comes to the rest of these ships, I want to know something. Torpedoes. 4.4. So, A, they have them, and B, they're dangerous. Because I would like to... Oh, hello. I would like to be able to approach them. But, at the same time, not too close. Whee! There goes another turret. And another. Okay, bye-bye battleship. That was a good fun 3 minutes. Is what she said. Anyway, that is one of the most dangerous ships out of commission. I do need those 3.1s into range. Oh, I'm going to have a bandwidth of about 800 meters to play around with. And if I can survive inside that bandwidth, great. If I get too close, I will get torpedoed. Now, let's eliminate the CA. Oh, sorry, the BC. Boom. Flooding. They're inside of a friendly smokescreen. We're going to have to close the distance here. Oh, there's another aggressive smokescreen over here. I'm pretty much broadside to you. Chance to pen me? Zero. Except for the barbettes. No, 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 no. Leave the heavy cruiser alive. Leave it alive. Wow, they actually damaged my engine? That is unexpected, really. The Colossus. Ha! Call that a Colossus?
That's what she said!
Sorry. Hey. Hey, hey, what's all this damage? What's all the damage? Eliminate that BC, because I'm taking more damage than I like. Thank you. British are having a grand old cook-off again. Are they gonna just pop their main turrets? Because in that case, I can let them live. I can let them live. All ahead flank, full 17 knots. Shit, it died. Okay, we're just gonna have to farm on the heavy cruiser, the light cruiser, and the DD. And the British tiers. Let's see what this thing has. This has a pretty sizable amount of secondaries. Do you come with torpedoes? You do. Six clicks out. Okay. So now I just get shot at for the next 17 minutes of in-game time. The Admiral with the most hits that were blocked by their ships, by their armor, is the winner. So, as much as it pains me to say, please hit this ship as much as you can. Which is something that these British ships don't seem to be terribly capable of doing. Your torpedo range is 6 kilometers. They only carry very few torpedoes, though, this Ribble. They got enough for one launch. What about these? See, this is pretty dangerous. They got 12 torps. They got 2 broadside. And Hermes? Oh, they just launched as well. Artport. Come on. Hit me. Ha! It's not even in the same zip code. Okay, so that was the DD. Oh, that's a bit more dangerous. Whee! Okay, so that was Bedford. Hermes still has plenty of torps. Bedford potentially also still has torps. Yep, she's turning her tail towards me. That is most likely going to mean we're going to be getting a gift. But she turned so fast that she overshot her torpedo chance. Oh, oh, no, I don't like that. That's going to hit me. No, it's going to hit the DD. Oh, wow, what a champ. What a champ. Okay, that is unfortunate, though. That is unfortunate. That's gonna hurt. Let's hope it's one dud. It is not a dud. What was that, actual two damaging hits? With the torps? Yeah. About 1400 points. Okay. Speed? Still about 14 knots, it's fine. Damage or amount of hits taken, 115 so far. I only have 8 minutes of in-game time left. That is not... Oh! All back emergency. Beep. Beep. There we go. Nice torps. Shame if something happened to my ship, though. Forward. Because Hermes likely is already readying up another shot. She only has one torpedo left, though. Now, this is definitely adding to my score. 189, 190, 200, 205. 230. Keep it up. Ribble's out of torps. Bedford just sent another salvo. All reverse. Oh, one splitting off. Nope. That actually hit me. Damn it. 4 minutes left. Now, the thing here is, Brother Monroe said... I'm going to pause this for a second. The post-battle results screen shows this as damaged tooltips. He screenshots. However, your ship is sunk, you get 0 points. Yeah, but am I supposed to, like, kill these ships off after 30 minutes? Because if I just click end battle or leave battle, I don't get a result screen. So how exactly am I going to be able to get this? I guess I just have to look at the amount of hits taken after exactly 30 minutes of in-game time. Because I don't really see an alternative. So for now, I'll just let them keep hitting me. As much as they can. We've taken how many hits now? A little under 400. Okay. 2.5 minutes left. Forward. 2 minutes. The Hermes is even starting to run low on high explosive ammo. Damn, they must be frustrated. I was worried about crew loss, but it's only 10%. So it's not nearly as bad as I thought. How are we going to eliminate this light cruiser? I can pen 5 inches of HE with HE, right? Oh yes. Load the HE. Prepare to fire. 40 seconds. What? That sneaky Batford heavy cruiser. Sneaky, sneaky man. Launching torps, almost hitting Hermes with that. And stop. Okay, 9 minutes 30. So I've played 30 minutes of in-game time. I have survived 608 hits out of 3,000 shells fired in my general direction. Not too bad. 600 hits. So that, over 30 minutes, 600 hits. And that, like I said, this is where the RNG part comes in. You never quite know what sort of ship the AI is going to build. If they build really good ones, like normal-sized battleships without a whole bunch of secondaries, you're a bit out of luck. If these guys are spamming high-end high-explosive, they will burn you down. So yeah, this is where some RNG is going to come in. Byron, you may open fire at your discretion. Oh, you missed. Reload. You see that light cruiser? I don't want to. Now you're catching on. And that's how you deal with light cruisers. Right, so after clearing up the rest of the ship, my score still stands. The amount of hits that I scored after 30 minutes is definitely not going to be the same as the ones you see here, because this battle lasted for longer than 30 minutes. So I don't think you should be taking the result screen from this, because this says 753, but we are actually establishing it was not quite that number. So, hope you enjoyed the battle. Let me know what your thoughts are down below in the comment section, and if you have a good challenge, by all means, post it down below. We're always open for new interesting challenges. Thank you guys for watching, hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you soon for more.